Welcome to Global Education Webinar, powered by Global Finance Squad.
I'm Mayank Patel from India. Right now, I'm serving as a knowledge manager in the Global Finance Board and also project manager for Google Education Webinar. I eat chocolates a lot. I'm foodie. I do a lot of adventures. I did my master's from accounting and finance from the University of Baroda.
I'm Mary. I'm 23 years old and I am a year five for today. I am currently SMB Finance and Legal of Isaac in Athens, Greece. And also I'm Knowledge Manager at Global Finance Board. Nice. So, what we have to see today, first of all, we will see what means to have a sustainable conference, what is a sustainable conference. Then we will see how to plan a conference, and we will see some really useful steps in order to know everything that we have to do. And the last part that we will see today is the role of the conference manager, because conference manager is a very, very important role in order to be sure that your conference will be sustainable, and we will see why. And then we have a space about Q&As. To continue with the session, we will start to see what makes a sustainable conference. So there are four steps. We see that all revenues cover all costs, meaning we break even or we have a profit. So when you have to plan your conference, you have to see all the revenues that you are going to have and to see all the expenses that you are going to have, because this will make you understand how many revenues you need in order to have a profit and not to have a loss. The second point is that the delegate fee, who the conference is for, should cover at least their costs. So you have to see all the costs that you are going to have in the conference, to see everything, to calculate everything, and then to see how much must be the delegate fee in order to be sure that it will cover all your expenses. The third part is that the fees should cover fixed costs such as the conference team's accommodation and food. So the fixed costs are really important, because if you don't do these costs, you cannot have the conference. The conference cannot exist. So you have to be sure that you have calculated these costs too, in order to be sure that the fee is this that is supposed to be. And the fourth point is that the revenue from sales should be for extras. We shouldn't depend on them. So of course in the company you will have sales, but you have to be sure that the profit that you want to have and the goal that you set in your budget is only from the revenues of the fees and not from the sales.
What do you mean by conference? So the first thing that when you heard about conference, what are the qualities and what are the elements that is common to event and project? All conference have, it's an objective to, like, we plan conference with some objectives to achieve. At the same time, it has beginning and the end. It is very temporary, time being event, so it has to start at certain point of time and it has to be end. And the most important thing is, like, it has budget constraint. So these three elements make conference a event, and event is equal to project. So project is very short term, a temporary project, so it has to start and it has to end very short period of time. Here you can see that we have cut down the entire session about how to plan and execute an event into how to. There are steps that you need to plan, you need to execute. So these are the two part of the event. So the step one.
First of all, you have to set the event's objective, and this is really important not to know what you have to do. The second step is to define the work packages or the components of the event, and to see how we will work, what we want to do. Then you have to make the plan, of course. The fourth step is to define the event structure. What do you need? If you need a team, what roles on the team do you want? What do you want to achieve? And the fifth step is that you have to make your budget, of course. So here we will analyze each step in order to be more clear for you. First step, set the image objective. What it means? That if you're doing a new kind of conference, first establish the objectives. Have them clearly identified and tracking. This will help you if you do a conference for the first time. It will help you in order to be more sure about what do you want to achieve through this conference. And it will help you in order to do your planning more analytically and to know exactly what you will need. But if you are doing a conference that's done before by your entity or your agency, review the objectives so they are clear for everyone involved. So if a conference has been done before, you have to see what objective we had there, what we want to achieve now, and also to have clear what you want and which roles you want again. Let's go to the second step. In the second step, as we said, we have to define the work packages. What this means? That breaking down the whole project into easily manageable packages and components that reflect the work that needs to be done. So, as Mayank said, of course the conference is a project, and in my opinion it's a big project that finance has to do. So, in order to be sure for the results that you want to have, you have to plan it through some steps. So you have to break down your plan and to say that in this package we want to achieve this, in this package we want to do this and achieve this. And this is more measurable for you, and then you can be sure about the tracking that you will have after. And its main package can be divided into simple components. It's really important to break it down as much as you can in order to be sure for this that you will achieve. To continue with the step number 3, you have to make, of course, your plan. This means that after breaking down the whole project into easily manageable packages or components that reflect the work that needs to be done. So it's more easy for you to do the plan and to know what you have to wait from this plan. Each main package can be divided into simple components, as we said before. Step number 4, define the event structure. It's really important to know what roles and positions you need in order to have a really good conference and a really good and sustainable conference. So you have to define the roles or positions you will need and the size of the team. How many VPs I will need? I will need CCV PR, I will need CCV PDS, and which is the goal of each CCV P for my conference? What I want to achieve through these positions? This is the team that will organize the whole event. It does not include the FASE team, so here we speak only for the OSI or CCI team, because this is the team that will organize the conference and all the operational things, let's say. The FASE team is there for another reason, to make all the moods of the conference and also to facilitate it. The OSI is there in order to organize it and to make it sustainable. The previous steps will help you decide what roles you need as you have identified the work that needs to be done. So, if you know the goal, if you know what you want to achieve, if you know the needs of your conference, then you can have a good structure about your event. And the last step that we have is to make the budget. Here you have to make an Excel table where you have the revenues and the expenses of your conference. Of course, you can see that the revenues is the delegates' fees, external sponsorships that may you have, and of course the budget that is needed for your conference. And the expenses are the traveling costs, the materials that maybe you will need, the venue. So you have to create three scenarios. You have to create three scenarios: a pessimistic, realistic, and optimistic. And why to do it? Because with this process, you will be sure for what you will achieve. And I will explain later what I mean. So, they can vary in amount of delegates, sales goals, material budget. So, the pessimistic, for example, will be a plan that you will plan that you will not have so much delegates, so the revenues from the fees will not be so much. Or that the expenses about the materials will be really higher than this that you are supposed to do. So this is a pessimistic plan. So now it's time to tell you a story, my story, about my first conference that I was a conference manager. Here in Greece, we used to have as conference manager the finance, the VP finance, especially in the LCs, not in the MC. So when I was as VP elect of finance and legal in my LC, I was supposed that I have to create my first local conference, but I had no idea what I had to do. So I started to think that I have to search about materials from previous local conferences. I found some things, but it was not enough. So then I analyzed any data that I had, and I started to plan what I want to have in my team to make the structure. I knew the objective, because the objective of the local conference was the same with the previous ones, but what I had to do is to plan this event. So I thought how many delegates maybe I will have, or how many positions I will need about my conference team, about my OC. And it was not an easy process, but it helped me a lot in order to organize my files.
Execute. So here we will understand a very four simple steps to execute the event. So it covers analyze where you can reduce cost and increase the revenue, modify and review the plan and budget. Step 3, make a risk management plan. And step 4, track and execute the event plan. So let us see each step one by one in details to have better clarity. So here we know in the step 1 that we need to analyze how to reduce cost and increase the revenue. So like to make conference sustainable, either we can have reduction in the cost or we can increase the income. So that is where that net effect would be increase in the net inflow. So how can we do it? So like we need to make sure that all the resources that we are going to use in the conference, either we reuse from the earlier event that happened, so it's like reuse purpose, or either we try to get more income through sponsorship, in-kind, or either you increase the source of income or you reduce the cost. So that way you need to analyze the status, that whatever things you plan, is it possible to make a changes, like is it possible to cut down the cost, or is there any possibility that you can increase the income? For example, you are going to use your notepads. Like if you are having conference, then you will need a delegation kit, but instead of spending some money for buying new delegation kit, you may check out that if you have already organized conference before and you may have a logistical like a delegation kit from the previous conference. So what you can do, probably you can try to rematerialize all the things, all the logistics that you already have in your inventory. So that way you can cut down the cost and you can also utilize the resources that is being already available with you. So that way how you cut down the cost. Next, modify and review plan and budget. So here, like here you focus more on like all the analysis that you have done in step number 1. You need to see that what are the possibilities to make changes and how you can do it. So like to understand the reality, you need to sit with your team, you need to discuss with them, and you need to ask some basic questions like what are the activities can be done at the same time by different people. So it would be more like do you think that is it possible to like have teamwork, like the same activity can be shared, like work shared with other team, and maybe at the same time you can see that if possible you can take help of CEDARS or NST, you can try to get help of other human resources to focus more, like to focus, like to have your team focus more on the things that they need to do. So you can try to check out the things that possibilities that when you made plan, you may have only 4 people on the board to work, or maybe 40 people, but at the passage of time you realize that you still have more resources or you need more. So that is where it's an alarm that you need to modify and review your budget. At the same time, what is the better thing that you can do? Like I think this is a common thing that you all guys have experienced in ISEC conferences. So that's time, like you will see that during a specific phase of conference, there will be so many tasks at the same time. So what happened that most of the people, like most of the team will be busy in that time. So what you can do, that either you can prepone some of the tasks that's going to be happen that time, or maybe you can have postpone, like you can postpone some of the activities that is possible. So if you do prepone and postpone, then during that point of time you will have more time to do a specific important thing that is required. So I think that is a strategy that you can use to utilize like average time and to give more focus on the things that is really needed. So that way you can manage time, like you can do a modification whenever is required. In step number 3, we'll have a risk management plan. So we have to make sure that when we are going to make event, we need to understand that what are the possibilities that occurrence of risk is there. So like we cannot say that like all is well and everything is going to be good. We, like as you know, Mari explained us that in conference we need to be like, we need to have 3 approach. We need to see that what is going to be the pessimistic approach, realistic approach and optimistic approach. But the moment you start with pessimistic approach, you need to be very conservative. You need to make sure that what are the probable things, what are the probable situation, events that are going to occur over there, and what are the probable impact that can happen to events. So for an example, that you might see that the location of the conference is very far from the city area. So what you will see that there will be a lack of transportation, and you may come to know that there are going to be some hike or something that time you won't be able to find transportation, and in the midnight it's going to be like risky or something. So you need to make sure that what are the probable risks that can happen in that event, and you need to make sure that you already have plan to mitigate that. And the probable reason can be like the safety of the delegates. You need to understand that make sure that there is no illegal things happens. Like you need to sustain in terms of legality, financial. You don't do any events where there is a loss of reputation. So you need to consider all the elements that is needed in an organization. So how can you do that? So you need to make sure that you have made a risk management tool where you make sure you write down all the possibilities, and with the possibilities you also go in the advanced mode. So you write down that there is going to be 10 or 20 possibilities that can happen, and you need to make sure that on each possibilities, what is the amount of frequency that can happen and what is the amount of impact that it can have on our conference. So it's all about like possibility of occurring the event, like impact and how huge impact that is have. So based on that, you can consider the risk management tool and you can make sure that you are ready for the conference. And the final step that we have in the execution of the conference, now it's time to make it like more realistic. So like you need to put down that what is going to, like you need to be sure that what is going to be the place, what is going to be the time, and which activity is going to be performed by when, how much time it's going to be. So you need to be ready with everything, and you need to start tracking the performance that is needed in the conference. And the most important thing here you need to do is that you need to do periodic follow-up with your team. So like you need to make sure that your team is doing everything on a time so that you don't end up with uncertainty or some accidents. Here it's a story time, so let me share you my story that I was executive body coordinator for a conference, that is June local congress in ISEC Baroda. Cool. So what we did, something like this, we made partnership for the goals. So how it is important, so it's very simple that when you are doing some conference or event, you just need to make sure that what are the objectives. We realize that we have some objectives. We want to give a really based kind of experience in the conference and high level of standards. So what we did, we went to the sponsors. We told them that this is the high quality of students that are going to be the participant for this conference, and by sponsoring us, you will get really good quality of customers, and you will have really good online market outreach. Through that market research, we reached to most of the people that who are willing to sponsor in such kind of business. So we did research, we had appointments one to one, and as a result of these efforts, like what we did, we got a lot of in-cash sponsorship and also in-kind sponsorship. So with this sponsorship, like, we achieve our objective. So the conclusion behind this story is that if you know that what is the limitation that you have with you, and you just need to focus that, okay, how can you align the goal of your event, like how can you achieve your objectives through partnership. So I hope this makes sense to you. Okay, so come back to the session. I have done with my story, and now Mary will let us know that what is the role of conference manager.
Nice. So as we discussed before, the role of the conference manager in a conference is really important, because it's the one person that will manage the team, the OSI team, and it's the one person that will track it in order to achieve the goal, to achieve the sustainability of the conference, because everything that we want to do, everything that the OSI has to do, if it's going to be done with the right way, we will be sure about the results that we will have. So, which are the roles of the conference manager? First of all, he has to select his team. This is the most important, the first important thing that he has to do in order to be sure about what he has to achieve at the end. So, then, before this, of course, you have to do, as we said, the structure, what structure you need. Then is the one that will lead the planning process. And this is really important, because the conference manager must be there in order to lead the team and to have the planning process in this way that will be really effective and efficient for the conference. Another thing that the conference manager has to do is to track and monitor the plan progress and also the execution of it. And this is really important. Yes, how do we make sure that the parts are sustainable and how do we make... For now, yes, this is not the sales part, I will explain it later. So, track and monitor, so he has to track and monitor the plan progress and also to track the execution of it. One of the most important things is the follow-up on each of the members of the OSI, because the conference manager is there in order to see, okay, my member has to do this, my OSI DS, for example, has to ensure that we will have a lot of delegates, this number of delegates. Is it happening or not? If it's not happening, what we have to do in order to achieve our goal? What do we have to change in order to achieve our goal, and also to have the appropriate forecasting in order to be sure about the results. The other thing is that the conference manager must make periodic review meetings. And here is the forecasting, that all the things that we said, we have to track it really constantly to be sure that everything is clear and every goal is achieved. If we don't achieve our goals, we have to do something about it. And then the conference manager is the one that will lead the team and act as communication channel between cross functions. So you have to be in contact as conference manager with all of your functions in order to be sure that everything is working well. And of course there are the synergies between the functions, so you have to be sure that the one function achieves its goal in order to be sure for the achievement of the goal of the other function.
When you're going through educational resources provided by Global Finance Board, that is, you go through YouTube channels, or you can also go through ISEC resource or ISEC hub. But sometimes you may get some questions while watching the videos and while reading the material that you have, like in online material, you may have some questions in specific topics. So here you can see that we have faces across the world who are going to deliver like specific session. So what you can do, like, just collect all the questions that you have during the journey of ISEC and make sure that you ask your question to them and you get, like, you know, you get answers to that. So one message is that you need to make sure that you need to plan and track the conference, but you need to make sure that conference should be either in break even or in profit, but it should not go in the loss, considering the independence of the event. At the same time, you need to make sure that depending on sales to cover cost is not sustainable. So you cannot put an excuse that we are going to have stall or we will sell the merchandise and this is going to be the income that will cover the cost. No, you cannot consider the sale income for the conference. So it's going to be extra. You need to keep it extra. You need to make sure that you cover all the fixed cost from the delegation fees or either you go for sponsorship or something. And the most important thing, how you can make conference sustainable, that is you need to ask yourself that when you are spending any of the money for expenses, you need to see that whether you are going to achieve the objective of conference by spending this money. If yes, then only go ahead. Otherwise, if you feel that it's not directly the objective, but you are just doing for the sake of like nice to have or like to just look good, then you should not waste, you should not spend money. You need to use money only for the betterment of the objectives. And at the end, you need to invest a lot of time and energy in your team. So OC and CC, because if you invest time in them, then they are going to give you more return in terms of smooth organization and like, you know, smooth coordination in the conference. So I think that is the base thing that even I have experienced in my term, that like you have to focus more and more on your team. If you have really good communication channel and if you are have really good expectations, I think setting with your team, then you will have a really wonderful conference waiting for you. Thank you so much for joining us in the Global Education Webinar.
If you have anything that you want to ask us, contact us. And also a point from my side is that the conferences are really important for our organization, for the engagement of the members, and generally in order to, for education, for a lot of things. But it's not what we did, what we do. So what we do is exchange. So you have to have in your mind that every conference that we have to do must be sustainable for the best of the entity, of the LC, and to be sure that we are here not to do what we do. That's from my side. If you want to ask us something, please contact us.
Also tell your colleagues about it.